Hey guys, just a six here again. Final thing. The opening at the stern of the boat for the rudder shaft, I made it larger. So what I did, took a piece of, I guess about 1 mil plastic from my trusty freezer bottle here. Drilled some holes, cut it, filed it, etc., etc. And a surgical glove. This rubber is extremely strong, and I don't know if it's rubber actually, but so I'm going to glue some pieces across this plastic plate, both sides. And top, bottom, and alternating layers to try and make some sort of seal. Not sure if it's going to work, but we'll try it. Now, the material these gloves are made of is like extremely thin and very stretchy. So what we'll do, we'll take the piece of plastic and using our trusty German grade Yoo-hoo, this is CA, to most of you, you'll be familiar with CA. I forget the technical term for it, but we'll just put a little drop here on the left side, and careful not to get it on your fingers because it's super glue. So I'll just stick the left side of this piece of plastic down on there and stretch out the rubber a little bit. This stuff dries like within 10 seconds. So then what we'll do is turn it over. Whoops. It's almost like skin, this stuff. Turn it over and apply super glue to the top line there, if I can get it right, and to the right side, or left as you're looking at it. So in effect what I'm doing is making a triple layer of rubber that hopefully will seal down on the rudder arm. So we just stretch that out a little bit and press down for a second. Hold that. And after a few seconds, that glue's going to take. And then, after waiting 30 seconds or so, what we'll do is we take our trusty scissors and we're just going to cut this out, just roughly for the time being. We can fine tune that shortly. So we just snip that out there. Like I said, this stuff is like skin, it's so thin. It's hard to cut a straight line, but we do our best here, just roughly for the time being. And we make a new place, a new piece. So you can see here, I haven't glued one side of it, or one top, bottom, whatever. This piece here is still unglued. What we'll do then is put it down with the opposite side glued, so it'll be glued to itself. Like so. So this side is the unglued side, unglued to the plastic, that is. So then what we'll do is apply some glue here to both ends, and to the opposite side of what we glued in the previous step. It's really hard to do this, actually. It's so thin. And of course we don't want to get it on our fingers. So then we lay that down on the sheet and give it a bit of tension, like so. Hold that for a few seconds. Again, it's super glue, so it's very fast. Does not seem to affect the composition of the rubber glove material, so hopefully it will not degrade over time. Sorry, just lighting up a cigarette there. We just hold that for a minute or 30 seconds or so, so that it sets. And then you can see now we have two layers, one glued at the top, one glued at the bottom. Take our trusty scissors and snip around the edges there. Again, this is just rough, doesn't matter that much. Just snip off the excess. And this is done in real time, so you can see that the glue is very fast. Get rid of those bits. This is probably a little bit boring as far as the video goes, but just thought I'd show you guys how I actually did it in real time. So whoops, off camera. So you can see how thin this stuff is, almost negligible visually anyway, difference to the piece of plastic. So this side's unglued, the top section is glued, And if I can get it back in the camera shot here, the initial layer is unglued on the opposite side. So it's kind of like a diaphragm, I guess. You can see there, it's very stretchy stuff, and extremely thin. I haven't measured it. I don't have any facility to measure that. So what we did then was do a third layer in the opposite direction with the same glue. So following on from the first layer, this is glued on both sides, glued on the top, and not glued on the bottom. So, whoops. Lay it down on the sheet again, stretching out a bit, give it some tension. Like so. So what I did here was we've got the three layers, one glued on each top bottom section. I took my blade and just put a little slit in the center so that it went through all three layers. And that allows us to pass through the carbon fiber rod with the fitting on the end. This is not the real one, but an example. So it passes through very easily. That's better. Now you can see the carbon. And a little bit of working in there. There we go. And you can see there's a tiny little slit in it, but which obviously will allow some ingress, but it's way better than the bare opening that you see in the original. So if we slide that on, actually, that's backwards. Let's put it on the right way around. So what we'll do is glue the plastic to the body of the hull there, like so. And you can see there's a very small opening, but it's I think it's going to work out. Okay. Whoops. Just to show you the movement of the servo pushing the rod in and out. It's pretty good, and actually there's not going to be that much movement in the arm because I've trimmed it down with my transmitter.